episode 2015, when the surprise surpasses the plan.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy day. Can you believe it? It's finally Friday. Yay! That means it's Confessions of an Upset Mama. And I gotta tell you, sometimes plans just don't work out. But you know what? When the surprise surpasses the plan, be ready for amazement. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com, where you can learn more and sign up for the K.I.S.S. newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. You know, strategic planning eases stress, right? We put things in order. It allows our minds to relax and be more at ease, and it can bring more happiness. Why? Well, because you have more direction. But when the surprise surpasses the plan, the heart and smiles ignite. There is nothing better than a surprise. But unfortunately, we leave our everyday moments to a calendar. I want you to think about that. We plan so many things in life. Dinner, what we're going to wear, what colors we're going to paint the wall, what books we're going to read, maybe what we're going to go buy, and even dreaming. We plan out everything. The plans can be so daunting that it suffocates flexibility and impairs creativity. Now, as you know, my youngest and I are in Kansas working on the family property. We're renovating two of the three homes on that property. Lots of little things to do and a lot of painting. In fact, yes, we're painting basically two homes by the time we're done with it and as many coats that I've been putting on it. But we've had a wonderful, great time. And as I look back, before we came out here, we had planned how this all was going to go down. We planned when we were going to paint what we were going to work on, what project, at what time. Do you think any of it worked out the way we planned it? Of course not. Something always gets in the way. And so my son was like, Mom, how much longer? Next day, Mom, how much longer? And it's not because he doesn't love being up here and spending time with his grandmother. That's not it at all. It's just that he's like, but I want to play, you know, my games with my friends. And some of the stuff that I do is back at home. And I don't have that here. And so we were doing something, and I don't remember exactly the conversation, but I made the comment. I said, you know what, son, sometimes surprises are better than the plans. And he looked at me and stopped, and he goes, you know, Mom, you're right. That's an episode. And I thought, you know what, that is true of life. We plan so much. We plan our wedding. We plan when we're going to get up. We plan when we're going to go to bed. We plan our dinners. It's all about this planning. And hey, you know what? I'm all about planning. I think it's very good. It makes us good stewards of our money. It keeps us on task. It allows us to really see what we need to do. We can also do further research. I mean, it plays into all parts of life, not just work, not just family. It's called life. Planning's great. But the thing is sometimes we begin to limit us. So instead of complaining about what isn't working, when your plans aren't going the way they're supposed to, embrace the surprise. That is your KISS to Keep It Simple strategy. Embrace the surprise. Some things just happen for a reason. You don't always know why in the moment, but it becomes a blessing in disguise. You got to look at the blessings. You got to look at the God winks where he shows up and you're like, oh, but that's not what I wanted. And you're like, but I'm so glad you gave it. But in between time, when your plans aren't working, you're frustrated and you're mad or you're just tired, whatever it is, right? It's all these roller coasters of feelings. And it's like, but why can't it just be what I want? Well, maybe there's a reason. It's a blessing in disguise. So how do you embrace the surprise, especially when you're the one who really doesn't like surprises? Now, it's great with birthdays, right? But not always with plans in other parts and areas of our life? Well, number one, flexibility. We've got to be flexible. Look for the beauty in the detours. I was driving home late last night. We went out to visit some family, and we came back. When I say late, like we were getting close to midnight, so it was almost today. And the crazy thing was, is we're driving, and we've got this driver in front of us, and he's just kind of doing his own thing. And on the other side, though, there's all these trucks. They're repaving the road. And they've got the big, giant lights out. And when I say there's a lot of trucks, this is a major city. And there are a lot of trucks. And it's for miles upon miles upon miles. And I'm sitting here going, dude, I'm tired. I still have to go home and paint some more. And my today is now turning into yesterday. And my tomorrow is now almost today. Talk about confusion. And then I was like, wait a minute. But there's also something I can look forward to. I'm enjoying time with my mom and my son that are in the car. We're enjoying our conversation. We're reflecting on what we did with family over the evening. But you know, I could have been just like, rah, 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 rah. And we get that way because things aren't fitting into our plan. It's a surprise. It's something unexpected. So you got to adopt flexibility. You got to stretch yourself a little bit. Don't be so what? Rigid. Yes, it's good to be rigid in some areas of life, like maybe disciplining your children. But when it comes to how things happen, how life shows up in our everyday, what that looks like, who we run into, look for the beauty in the detours. Whether they're paving your roads, whether you're standing in the grocery line, or whether you're just at home trying to fix dinner. Look for that beauty. Number two, gratitude. We've got to adopt an attitude of gratitude. Appreciate where you are now and where you are going along the journey. Don't get flustered. I know for me, it's easy to get flustered. I'm like, seriously, come on. Don't you get this by now? And I'll have a conversation. No one even has to be around. I'll talk to the wall sometimes. Okay, I'm not actually looking at a wall and talking to the wall, but it's frustrating. And so you just start talking and you have these conversations. It's a whole monologue that's going on. But instead of being upset and flustered, adopt the attitude of gratitude and say, you know what? I know I don't like that this is happening, but where can I find the silver lining? Where can I find the little rose petals? But you're not going to find them unless if you're looking for them. Flexibility, gratitude, and finally, number three, patience. I don't know about you, but I need to adopt patience every single day. Number one, because for me personally, come on, it's confession day, so let's lay it all out there on the line. I'm pretty much a perfectionist. I want things done the right way the first time, whether I do it or whether somebody else does it. I want it done right. Now, does that always happen? Oh no, it doesn't. And guess what? It gets me into trouble. Meaning that if I want a project completed, I may absolutely do the entire project because if a mistake is done, guess who I can blame? Only myself. But oh my goodness, if I delegate it or give it to one of my children or let the dog do it, whatever, then if something happens, it doesn't go as planned, then what? Well, it's not just my fault. Now it's somebody else's fault. You may want things your way, but when you have lemons, you got to learn how to make lemonade. It's called life. We don't always get to dictate how we want our life to play out. Yes, we can plan it. Oh, we can hope that it's all going to work out and we can try to connect every single dot and make everything happen, but it doesn't always work that way. So guess what? Surprises can be so much more fun when it comes to birthdays, anniversaries, and holidays. But in real life, we know that anything disrupting our norm puts us on the defensive. It makes us uncomfortable. Don't gamble your days away by placing your bet only on a plan. Yes, plan where you can, but when surprised, embrace the surprise. Embrace the opportunity of change. Change is a constant. And whether we like it or not, oh, we got to be willing to stretch ourselves. Otherwise, we're just going to whittle up and we're just going to die. And we don't want to be that way. I know you don't want to be that way. And especially when it comes to raising our children, we have got to be ones that say, you know what? I may have wanted this at this time, at this place, but it's not going to happen. So I'm going to figure out another way to handle the situation or another way to look at the situation. The grass isn't always greener on the other side. Just because you have a plan that you think is going to work out perfectly doesn't mean that that is the plan of how it's going to work out. So give yourself some grace when you embrace the surprises. Look for those detours. Find that beauty in them. Have that attitude of gratitude. And most importantly, be patient, not only with yourself, but with your children, your husband, your wife. Love on them. Be patient because life is too precious. Go out today. Be present. Be incredible. Be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a beautiful, blessed weekend. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.